is day one of incubation. We have 20 chicken eggs and 6 duck eggs. So I just got the temperature all set, so I'm not going to keep that open long. And chickens will hatch in from 19 to 21 days from now, and the duck eggs take, I believe it's 28 days for the ducks to hatch. All right, so it's day 7, and I'm not gonna leave that open very long. Today we're gonna show y'all how you can check the eggs to see if they're fertilized, to see if they are forming into a chick, and we'll show y'all how we do that. So we're gonna check for veins. You see that movement? It's already moving.
Is that the one in the middle?
Yeah.
The ones in the middle stay warmer than the ones on the outside, so they develop faster.
Way faster. That is already moving. That is a chick. This is day 7, guys. So.
You can see the veins now.
You see the veins.
See it popping around. Bouncing.
See the veins up through here. And then the baby right up in there moving around. That is pretty awesome. Let's put it back so it doesn't get cold. That one is a small white egg. And let's get this big one back here. Let's see if we can see anything in this big fella. Kind of hard to see. But I see some lines in there. I don't know if you'll be able to see it on the video.
Yeah, you can see it right there on the side.
Mm-hmm. If you know what you're looking for. It's kind of hard to tell if you don't know what you're looking for. But it's developing too. And some of these will have nothing but the yolk. Let's check a duck egg. Let's check a duck egg. I put these in at the same time. See that? Oh, look now. Hang on, let me adjust. Look at that.
You see the air sac at the top.
Yeah, that's the air pocket right there. And you see the striping. Are you at a good angle here?
Is there a line all the way around it?
Yeah.
Because there's a line all the way around it and it's dead.
That's probably dead. Okay, look. Yeah.
Yeah, it's dead.
Oh, it didn't make it.
It didn't make it because there's something wrong with the egg.
It's chipped. Oh no, that egg was chipped. Yeah. I didn't even notice that. Oh, that one didn't make it. Okay, well let's show this again because, okay, if it was to make it, this dark spot right there wouldn't be there.
Yeah, and they call it it's called a death ring.
Right, and let me show them the veins. The veins, you see those little lines through there? Those are the blood veins. But this, Okay, so this darkness through here, all through there, that's because it died.
You'll know if the egg's dead because there's a definite line of
a
red.
Dark line.
It goes all the way around.
All the way
egg.
Around. And it's just kind of jiggling around in there when I'm moving it.
Yeah,
That's blood. That's blood in there because it didn't make it.
Usually they say if there's eggs with cracks on them, but it doesn't go all the way through, you can put
fingernail polish.
Clear fingernail polish over the crack, and it might save it. But
it looks like that one went all the way through. Dadgummit, I didn't even notice that. Okay, let's try one more duck egg, and then we'll stop opening it because we're letting a lot of heat out. That one was developing. This one, I don't know, Josh. Mm-hmm. I think this one's just a yolker.
Yeah, it's not good.
This one looks like it's not even developing. I like to be safe about it, and we're going to give it a couple more days and see if it starts developing veins.
It's not
going to
make it.
I don't like to give up on them that fast. Okay, since that one was a bad one, we can tell that was a yolker. Let's try this one. Oh, man. It looks like this is a yolk or two, or our duck eggs just may not, most of them may not develop.
Yeah, well, they're not fertile.
Okay, well, maybe some of the ducks in there are fertile. On the
chicken eggs on day 19, we move them to a different incubator where the humidity changes and they'll start hatching within a day or so.
If any of the duck eggs make it.
But no, that's the chickens. The ducks, they're a whole week after chicken eggs. It takes ducks longer to hatch. So that's why I'm thinking, give them a couple more days and we'll check for the veins, because the ducks take a lot longer to develop. So maybe, we'll see. All right, guys, so today is the day. Today we move them to the hatching incubator. Around day between 17 and 19, you move them, you stop turning them, because this incubator has the turner. It moves them back and forth throughout the day, like a mama would. And so normally it's day 18 that you move them, but today is the morning of day 19 because we were having some trouble getting our temperature and humidity right on our incubator, but we've got it now. So we're gonna move them over and show y'all what it looks like after we do that. These over here are ones that we've candled or flashlighted, basically, and we could clearly see that they were either not fertilized or they had died. They were fertilized and started to grow, but did not make it past a certain time. So we're gonna get these out and get them in the other incubator. So another thing is to, when you're putting eggs in the incubator, always be sure that I'll show you over here, that the pointy side, the what you would think as the top of the egg, the pointed side, make sure that is down. That has to go down when you're hatching eggs, because the big part is the part that they hatch from at the end, and that part has an air pocket in there, and that's how the chick will get out. And so if you do it this way and that air pocket forms up here in the wrong end, the chick will most likely not be able to get up in there and be able to, you know, break through and get out. So always be sure that it is pointed side down when you're incubating. I'll show you my eggs that I moved. When you move these, now you very carefully lay them on their side, and those chicks will begin to move into position to get ready to hatch. And they should hatch in the next day or two. Some of them may even start hatching by tonight. Can y'all hear that? Do y'all hear that? This is day 20. And this one right here, this white one, is pipped. For sure that one, and maybe even a couple others, but I can't tell. But I know this white one right here has pipped. Pip is just the word you use when they just poke a little hole in the outer shell where you can see they're starting to hatch. They have just a little pip hole where their little beak has poked through the shell. And then once they start making a whole line, cracking the whole shell all the way around it, that's called a zip. They zip all the way around. So right now we're just pipped, and it could take almost a whole day for them to actually hatch. But do you hear? Do you hear that? See that right there? That's the baby's beak poking in and out of the little hole, and you can see it breathing out of the little hole. See it moving? I was sleeping. It is 1:30 a.m. Kind of missed it for y'all. Yeah, I didn't get the hatching. I'm so sorry. Maybe the next couple, I'll get them on video. But there's our first chick of the season. That baby is just fine in this box until he is dry and fluffy. You do not have to take them directly out of the incubator. They can stay in here until they're completely dry. I may not do that because my humidity is really high in the incubator, so I'm gonna probably take him out before he's, you know, completely dry and fluffy. And I say he, like it's the universal term. I would like to think that it's a hen. It's a sheep. And there is my other two that are pipped. There's that one, and then there's one, this one right here, that's got a little bitty pip. And this is the only two right now that we have pipped. Trying to get his feet. Another thing, when one pips and hatches and starts chirping like crazy like this, it kind of encourages the rest of them to start, especially if you put them all in at the same day. This one right here is starting to break through more now because he hears his little sibling over here chirping away, calling for somebody to come out and play. And so he's wanting to get out of here now. You can kind of see, kind of hard to see, but you kind of see that one's starting to break away more. He's starting to dry off a little more. He's about to go out of here very soon. In the next little bit, he's going to go into the brooder box where he's going to have some pine shavings and a heat lamp. Be nice and warm. He's maybe about an hour and a half to 2 hours old. He's starting to walk around. And he's about to go out to the big chick tub. Alright, so it's 2:45 in the morning. If any of you have animals or hatch chicks, you know that it can be a late night thing. They hatch the wrong time of day a lot of times. So just wanted to say, always, if you are messing with baby chicks, wash your hands first. I've washed my hands, got them good and dry and warm, so I can transport this little guy from the incubator to his brooder box in the next room. We're not going outside. His brooder box is in the house, so he's not going to get too cold. Some little baby. We'll have friends here shortly. There you go. He'll finish drying out and get all fluffy in there. He's got a set of lungs on him. Alright, so once again, I missed it, and this little guy just got out of his shell. And look what it is! It's a turkin! Yay! We love it when we get turkin babies. I do anyway. I think they're so fun. And it's so weird looking. They're so goofy looking, but they're so fun. It's another black turkin. This one's getting ready to zip out of his shell. And that one's a yellow one. I can see the color. This one over here is pipped. You can see the turkin's ears when they're born. You can can see their ears. They're so strange looking. See his little ear hole? Little guy. This one's getting there. So weird. His skin is almost translucent. It's really weird. There he comes. Kick it off, little guy. You're so tired. It's hard work coming out of there. Hi. Welcome to the world. There you are.